totally faking it. Yeah. I mean, it's hilarious.
This episode is sponsored by Unbound and made possible by viewers like you.
I'm angry. I'm frustrated. I can't sleep at night. I'm anxious. I'm depressed. The medicine is not working, and I am still here because I am a man.
What's this? This WWE?
The medicine is not working!
Gen Z trash talk now.
Yeah. I'm depressed!
The medicine is not working, but I am still here because I am a man!
Still here.
I felt like a real boomer the other day. I walked into a GameStop and the employees, the guy was training the girl. She was a new employee. And they're just sitting there talking about all the different medications they're on for all their different depressions and everything. All I could think was, man, this is not the conversations we had when I was working retail as a teenager.
I'm angry.
Interesting world.
This is not good.
We're not in Kansas.
This is not good.
Did you see this clip when it happened?
Oh my god!
I've seen some memes about it that have made me laugh. This is the best one. It's amazing.
Oh man.
Likes what he sees.
My favorite Dan Bongino meme yet.
That's not actually Dan Bongino.
No, it's not. It's just another man who's shaped like a raisin. When you die and Jesus shows you a list of all the memes you liked,
I'm in danger.
You just know this is the pastor's daughter.
When your check engine light goes on, so you pray about it. Mechanic.
I don't understand this. I don't get it.
It's, you know, guys who don't go to church and they're like, I experience God in nature, and then the true alphas. I go to church, and the true alphas are apparently just AI images.
That's what I thought was a little weird. I was like, where's the insult?
What is?
They're fake people.
What is that AI look that as soon as you see it, you can tell? Are they all coming from the same app or something?
I don't know.
Like, as soon as I see these YouTube thumbnails, I'm like, that's AI. Like 1,000%. This is one of those things that I always thought made me weird that I thought about. But
you thought about that?
I'm seeing memes now where people are like, hey, I'm just sitting here thinking about what would happen if
it all went wrong.
It all went wrong quick.
Who's the first to go? Where do I lay in line?
Dude, I do that everywhere I go.
Do you?
If I was sitting in a restaurant or something, I literally like scope out my exits.
Well, I don't necessarily scope out my exit, but I sit down and I assess who gives me the feeling that they could go rogue. Whenever anybody walks in, Sarah always calls me FBI Jordan. I sit down, I can barely concentrate with her because I'm just sitting here and I'm like, Sarah, these people are talking about that person over there, their child. And it's like, it's a problem, Josh.
There's a lot of guys that can skateboard real good, but they're not doing it for the Lord. It doesn't matter how good you are, it's what your attitude is. That's what God really cares about. You skateboard for him and not to show up in front of your friends.
So I skateboard for the Lord?
You do everything for the Lord. You mow the lawn for the Lord, wash dishes for the Lord.
There's, like you were saying, this AI feeling. There's this Christian's 90s feeling.
Yeah.
Like the same person wrote the scripts. I don't know who they are, but the same person wrote every single script.
And it also looks like it was shot on the set of The Donut Man.
It does. The only four types of boys to date in youth group. Yeah, I can think of an exact guy for that bottom left, an exact guy for the top left.
For all of them.
All of them.
When I see the homie at church that I haven't seen for 16 hours, big dog.
It should say you haven't seen for 5 hours because you go to church in the morning
right.
And church in
yeah,
the evening.
That's right.
Nobody, church sound guys. This is exactly true for our old church and everybody else's
and
old
everybody's
church.
Old church, allegedly. Yeah.
Audience, expecting Josh to step in during Jordan's latest conspiracy theory on the podcast. Josh, no, he's got a vlog. Did you make that one, Josh?
I did. They expect Amazing. Me to be a plug in the dam, but I am not.
Not anymore.
No. He just hear him out.
There's a little nugget of truth somewhere.
There's something there. Hey, go check out the podcast. Search Blimey Cow Podcast. It's here on the channel every Friday. Boy, we've just come up on 40 episodes, if you can believe
it. I know.
This.
If you don't love it, we'll give you $100.
Give you your money back.
Yeah.
Cats are so cute. I've never heard that song. Are you familiar with that song?
No.
It was acting like it was popular 10 years ago. It's in 2014. This was a bop. Anybody else heard that song? I think it was Hillsong.
Oh, maybe. I just thought that was generally saying that for any worship song, the part where it's like there's that sick drop, Josh. That beats.
When the Holy Spirit boosts
in. You'll jump around.
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question. Have you ever taken a personality test hoping that it would explain you to you? Did you find yourself slightly comforted because it kind of matched who you are, but not really? So you just tried to force yourself into a box just to feel a little understood?
Don't do that. There is a better way. We've gotten such great feedback about this book that the folks at Unbound have made available exclusively for Blimey Cow viewers.
That's right. It's called the Personal Triangle, and it is not a personality test. No, it is much better than that. It is a model to help you capitalize on your core strengths. You'll have to intentionally account for your weaknesses and then grow in the direction that your interests take you.
Unbound specializes in training young adults with the skills and abilities they need to live and work effectively in the real world. They're really great guys and gals, and they're personal friends of the channel and have been faithful sponsors for many years.
Yes, they have been. Your gifts, your skills, and your strengths, you can't cram them into 9 categories, 16 types, or 14 stupid quadrants, okay?
14 quadrants.
Sorry, 4.
You are far more uniquely created than that. So if all this sounds good, visit beunbound.us/blimeycow to download your free full-length copy of that book, The Personal Triangle, today.
Josh, you might be able to cram yourself into 14 quadrants. That is a lot of quadrants, but I meant to say 4.
I bet there's even more personality tests.
Oh, now. I'm sure. Just go on Facebook. You don't have a Facebook. Beunbound.us/blimeycow.
All right, let's get back to the memes.
I'm so bored, I've been trying to get these two to tell me Bible stories for the past hour. That looks exactly like them.
I know, it does. Bible college tuition should be based off of what you will actually make doing ministry. So true. I can't imagine going to a Bible college and spending more than like $300, $400.
Did AI make this?
I don't know.
It gives me that feeling. We might read the same Bible, but I read it better than you.
He's
literally faking it. Yeah, I mean, it's hilarious. It's like a Disney movie?
No, it's a telenovela.
Oh, I've watched those.
Yeah, we got some Calmunity memes too. Hey.
Oh. Speaking of
We're doing a terrible job, I would say, so far of explaining that we have a new supporter community.
Oh, but it's going incredibly well, Josh,
really,
and you're missing out.
SupportBlimeyCow.com no longer takes you to Patreon. It takes you to our website where you can become a supporter today. $5 gets you everything, bonus messages, bonus segments of the podcast, a page where you can send us memes, which we're about to show you some of the memes from the supporters.
Yeah.
So anyways, go to SupportBlimeyCow.com.
We've been doing typing tests, Josh.
Yes.
I have a typing group on there for all the nerds out there, and I'm getting blown out of the water.
Are you really?
Josh, I haven't done typing in so long. So like I'm at 65, 80 words a minute, and we got some people in there doing 110.
Dude, that's funny. All right, let's look at some of these supporter memes. Jesus, table of 26, please, but there are only 13 of you. Yes, we're all going to be sitting on the same side.
At long last, I have found it. People that send in messages. The man which utters only truth. Some of your problems are your fault. Okay, wow, you little jerk, you don't know me. People that send in messages. Yep.
You
that's a
little
cool.
Jerk.
Who made this up?
I think his name is Ian? He's new in the community.
I-A-N?
E-Y-A-N. Like Evan, but with a Y.
Okay.
Yeah, so shout out to you, buddy.
Ian, if that's your name. An amazing meme.
Adam and Eve, sin, God, your game mode hasn't been updated to survival mode.
I'm sure that's a Minecraft.
It is Minecraft.
I don't understand it.
You can play in creative mode where you can fly and you have unlimited resources, and survival mode where the creepers will come after you. We play in creative mode in this.
Of course. If someone majors in Old Testament studies, does that count as a law degree?
The old Velociraptor. It's been a while since I've seen that meme.
I've never seen it.
The Velociraptor? That's it.
Wow, guys. The Jordan's message is one... Amazing. Thank you. I'm biased, but it was great.
All right, everybody. Go check out the podcast. Messages next week. More Christian meme review before the month is over. We got all kinds of stuff happening here on the Blimey Cow channel and at supportblimeycow.com.
That's right.
All right.
We'll see ya.
See y'all soon.
Bye-bye.